The basilisk is called the Jesus Christ lizard because it can walk, well, really run on water. It bicycles its hind legs, and the tail becomes a counterweight.
I could do that.
There's no way.
All I need is wood.
I got you.
Obviously, our idea behind this is to simulate the lizard in the video and that we could walk across water. And as you can see, it didn't really go so well. So in this part, we're going to talk a little bit about some of the theory and math behind this. And the whole idea is sort of revolves around surface tension. Surface tension is it's a force that resists external forces, with dimensions force per unit length, or energy per unit area, which is also known as surface energy. Some examples that we'll show you later are the example of the water strider and of the Jesus Christ lizard.
So now, what would it take for a person to be able to walk on water using only surface tension? Well, assuming that surface tension is about 7.34 times 10 to the negative 2 newtons per meter, and the person weighs about 750 newtons, that would be 10,218 meters, or about 6.35 miles for those using Queen's English. So, that's our person. His shoes would have to look something like this.
So if we use this equation, L equals weight divided by surface tension, we can find the one-dimensional interface length that we will need to stand on water. Here's a free body diagram for the water strider. And now if you work out the problem, assuming the weight of the water strider is 10 to the negative 4th newtons, then you get an interface length of 1.36 meters, but that's only in one dimension. For a lizard, the weight's about 1.96 newtons, which will give it a total one-dimensional length of 26.7 meters. Bear in mind, this length is overly large since the lizard traps air pockets underneath its feet.